Let's compare Windows 11 Insider Preview Build 22000.51 with Windows 11 Leak Build 21996.1. On the left we have Windows 11 Leak Build 21996.1 and on the right we have Windows 11 Insider Preview Build 22000.51. Let's compare the locked screen. In the leak, the clock is in the bottom left. In Insider Preview, the clock is in the top center. In Insider Preview, the icons in the bottom right of the sign-in screen have been updated. In the leak, the power options menu has square corners. In Insider Preview, it has rounded corners. In the leak, the clock shows the weekday in between the date and time. In Insider Preview, it only shows the date and time, even though the taskbar is the same height in both. In the leak, there is a notification center icon to the right of the date and time. In Insider Preview, there is not. In the leak, it brings up a pane at the side with notifications at the top and actions at the bottom. In Insider Preview, when you click on the clock, the notifications are at the top and the calendar is at the bottom and they have rounded corners and float. In Insider Preview, when you click the network and volume icons, it brings up the actions with a volume slider underneath. In the leak, the network and volume icons are separate. In Insider Preview, they are combined. In the leak, the calendar is square and touches the edges. In Insider Preview, it is rounded and floats. In the leak, there is an agenda setup below the calendar. In Insider Preview, there is not. In the leak, there is a glow that follows the mouse. In Insider Preview, there is not. In the leak, when you clear all notifications, the notification area is empty. In Insider Preview, when you clear all notifications, the notification area goes away. In Insider Preview, when you hover over search, it shows recent searches, and when you hover over task view, it shows a quick view of the desktops. In the leak, it does not. In the leak, when you right-click the start button, the menu has the frosted glass effect. In Insider Preview, it does not. In Insider Preview, Windows PowerShell has been replaced with Windows Terminal. In Insider Preview, the user account control prompt has been updated. Let's compare the settings app. In the leak, the icons use flat design. In the Insider Preview, the icons use material design. In the leak, the main categories are displayed full screen when the settings app is opened, and when you click one, the subcategories are displayed down the left with the subcategory contents to the right. In Insider Preview, the main categories are displayed down the left and the subcategories within the selected main category to the right. When you click a subcategory, the right switches to displaying subcategory contents. In the leak, the settings items have square corners. In Insider Preview, they have rounded corners. In the leak, to switch to a different subcategory within the same main category, you click it on the left. In Insider Preview, you have to go back to the selected main category and select a different subcategory. In the leak, to select a different main category, you have to go back to the homepage and then select it. In Insider Preview, you select it down the left. In the leak, the pane at the left of the settings app is made of frosted glass. In Insider Preview, it is not. In Insider Preview, you can apply themes to the touch keyboard. In the leak, you cannot. Let's compare the File Explorer. In the leak, we have the ribbon interface and a file menu. In Insider Preview, we have some buttons along the top. In Insider Preview, there is a new button that lets you create a new folder or item. In the leak, these options are under the new group of the Home tab. In Insider Preview, along the top there is Cut, Copy, Paste, Rename, Share and Recycle. In the leak, Cut, Copy and Paste are under the Clipboard group of the Home tab, and there are also options to copy path and paste shortcut. Rename and Delete are under the Organize group of the Home tab, and you can either permanently delete or recycle, and you can choose whether to show the recycle confirmation. There are also options to move or copy directly to a folder. In Insider Preview, there is a button that brings up a list of sorting options. The common options are there, and there is a submenu for more sorting options. There is also a submenu for Group By. In the leak, the Sort button is under the Current View group of the View tab, and you can choose more columns. The Group By option is also under the Current View group of the View tab, and there is an option to size all columns to fit. In Insider Preview, there is another button to bring up a menu of layout options. It also has Compact View and allows you to show or hide different panes, checkboxes, file extensions or hidden items. In the leak, the layout options are under the Layout group of the View tab, and it gives you a preview which Insider Preview does not. The options to show and hide panes are under the Panes group of the View tab, and the options to show and hide checkboxes, file extensions and hidden items are under the Show/Hide group of the View tab. In Insider Preview, you can enable Compact View in the menu. In the leak, you have to go to the Options dialog. You can also do this in Insider Preview. In Insider Preview, there is a button that brings up a menu with Zip, Copy Path, Select Options, Undo, Properties and Options. In the leak, Zip is under the Send group of the Share tab. Copy Path is under the Clipboard group of the Home tab. Select Options are under the Select group of the Home tab. Properties is under the Open group of the Home tab, and Options is under the View tab. In the leak there is a quick access toolbar where you can add items from the drop-down menu, and you can also add any item by right-clicking it and clicking Add to Quick Access Toolbar. In Insider Preview there is no quick access toolbar. Let's compare the right-click menu. In Insider Preview, cut, copy, rename, share and delete are icons at the top of the menu. In the leak they are items on the menu. In Insider Preview the menu items are more spaced apart than they are in the leak. In Insider Preview it says the keyboard shortcuts next to the options, in the leak it does not. In Insider Preview most of the menu items have icons, in the leak most do not. In Insider Preview copy as path is in the menu, in the leak you shift right click to get this option. In Insider Preview you can click show more options which brings up the old menu. In Insider Preview the menu that you get when you right click the desktop has also been updated. And you can click show more options to bring up the old menu. In the leak when you right click an icon on the taskbar the menu has square corners and touches the taskbar. In Insider Preview it has rounded corners and floats. In Windows 7 it also has rounded corners and floats. In Windows 8 and 8.1 it has square corners and floats. In Windows 10 it has square corners and touches the taskbar. In the leak the Ctrl-Alt-Delete screen is the accent color. In Insider Preview the Ctrl-Alt-Delete screen is black. In Insider Preview the store logo has been updated. In the leak the store is the same as in Windows 10. In Insider Preview the store has been completely redesigned. In the new store the header has a glow that follows the mouse. In the old store the header goes dark. In the old store items have square corners. In the new store items have rounded corners. In the old store there is a frosted glass top bar. In the new store there is not. In the old store there is a search button in the top right. In the new store there is a search bar along the top. In the old store the categories are along the top. In the new store the categories are down the side. In the old store my library is accessed through the menu in the top right. In the new store my library is in the bottom left. Let's compare the widgets dashboard. In Insider Preview it has widgets at the top and a news feed below. In Insider Preview there is an Add Widgets button. In the leak there is not. In Insider Preview you can change the size of the widgets. You can also remove widgets. In the Insider Preview there is a search bar at the top. In the leak there is not. In Insider Preview you can click on a widget for more information. However for some reason it opens in Microsoft Edge rather than in the app. Goodbye.